वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर टुडे दैट इज ऑन स्प्रिंग्स. वी विल बी कवरिंग इन टू लेक्चर्स दिस लेक्चर दिस चैप्टर. सो इन द लेक्चर वन वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग व्हाट इज द इंट्रोडक्शन टू द स्प्रिंग, व्हाट दे आर, व्हाट इज द मटेरियल ऑफ द स्प्रिंग, हाउ देयर एप्लीकेशन इज. सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद द कॉन्टेंट. फर्स्ट इज व्हाट इज अ स्प्रिंग. स्प्रिंग इज डिफाइंड एज ए इलास्टिक बॉडी हुज फंक्शन इज टू डिस्टॉर्ट व्हेन लोडेड एंड टू रिकवर इट्स ओरिजिनल शेप व्हेन द लोड इज रिमूव. सो एज ए लेमैन यू नो दैट स्प्रिंग लुक्स लाइक दिस. So when you apply the load, it compresses. When you apply the load, it compresses like this. And when you remove the load, so it regain its shape. So we can also define that spring is a resilient member which is capable of providing the large elastic deformation. So it is elastic deformation. That means when we remove the load, it comes back. It is also defined as an elastic body that can be twisted, pulled, or stretched by some force. They can return to their original shape when the force is relieved. So important application. Mechanical springs are used for the wide application. The first is to cushion or absorb or control the energy, either due to the shock or the vibration, as in the case of the car spring you have seen, in the case of the railway bogie, aircraft's landing gear, shock absorbers in the case of the automobiles, and the vibration dampers. The vibration dampers we are using in the foundation for the machines. Second application is to apply the forces in brakes, as in brakes, clutch, and the spring-loaded valves. Third is to control the motion by maintaining the contact between the two elements, as in cams and followers. Fourth is to measure the forces, as in the case of the balances and engine indicator. And the last is to store energy in the case of the watches and the toys. So earlier you have seen the mechanical watches which we use to wind up to store the energy for 24 hours, and the movement was taken through the gears. Similarly, in the case of the toys also, we wind the key and we store the energy. So what are the different spring materials? So there are the spring is made up of the some special material. So these are the lists. So one is the hard-drawn high carbon steel. So high carbon steel is the simple material which we use. Second is the oil tempered high carbon steel. Third is the stainless steel. The springs can be of copper nickel based alloys. It can be a phosphor bronze, inconel, monel, titanium, and chrome vanadium. So these are the materials which are used for the manufacturing of the springs. So to apply the, what is the uses of the spring? So to apply the forces and to control the motion, as in brakes and the clutches. To measure the forces in the spring balance, to store the energy, to reduce the shock impact, and to change the vibration characteristics. So this is one of the same thing which we have discussed in the application. So now next is, what are the different types of the springs? So springs are classified based on its shape, geometry, or the nature of the stressing, etc. So based on the shape, it can be wire springs, the flat springs, and the special shaped springs. you see laminated spring, and these are the disc springs. So advantage of springs, mostly the spring is used for avoiding the vibration. So because of the sudden vibration in the car, it may affect the human and causing vomiting and so much of discomfort. To avoid the vibration in machine, it increase the life of machine. To apply the force and controlling motion in the case of clutches and brakes, and to help in storing the energy as in the case of the watches. So what are the disadvantages? If the deflection of the spring exceeds some critical value, then the spring will buckle. Okay, it's difficult to replace the spring when it is worn out. So you have to, it is difficult. Then once the spring is damaged, it is difficult to repair. Okay, you have to replace it. So first of all, we will study what are the helical springs. So a helical spring, in the shape, it will look like this. The wires is in the shape of the helix. So helical spring is also known as the coil spring. It is a mechanical device which is used to store energy and to subsequently to release energy to absorb the shock and to maintain the contact between the two surfaces. They are made of elastic material which are formed into the shape of helix. So helix angle is like this, like this, which returns to its natural length when unloaded. So type of helical springs, they are in the course. They can be open coil helical spring, or we also call them as the tension helical spring or extension spring. And the other type is the closed coil helical spring. So they are also known as the compression spring. Third type of the spring is a torsion spring and the spiral spring. So we will be discussing only these two springs which are there in your course. So helical extension spring. So a helical extension spring looks like this. So everybody must have seen this. So there are two, these are the eyes of the spring used for gripping, and this is the effective length. So it has some means of transferring the load from the support to the body. It stretches apart to create the load. The gap between the successive coil is small. So this gap is very small, this gap. You'll see the wire is coiled in sequence, that is, the turn is at the right angle to the axis of the spring. So this is the axis of the spring, and the turn is normally at right angle. But if it is at some certain angle, then it is a helix angle. The spring is loaded along the axis. So this is the loading axis is shown. Okay. By applying the load, the spring elongates in action. So when you apply the loads, as I told, the spring will stretch, the length will increase. Similarly, the second type is the compression or the compression helical spring. So these are the, compression helical springs. So there no eye is given, you see. So they look, it is plain-ended, it is plain and ground. It is squared, this end is square, and the squared and ground. So ground means they have been made leveled. So it is squared. So this is ground means they are at the same level. So among the four types, the plain end type. The plain end type is less expensive to manufacture. It tends to bow sideways and when applying the compressive load. So this type of spring is easier to manufacture and least expensive. Then the torsion spring. It is also a form of the helical spring, but it rotates about the axis to create the load. It releases the load in the arc around the axis, mainly used for the transmission of the torque. The end of the springs are attached to other for the application object, so that the object rotates around the center of the spring. It tends to push the spring to receive or retrieve its normal position. Then there are spiral spring. Spiral spring is in the form which is used in the clocks. it is made up of band of steel wrapped around itself a number of times to create the geometric shape. So it is a strip, you see, it is a strip, it is not wire, it is a strip, horizontal strip. So it is strapped like this. So mainly it is used in the case of gauges, in the case of the clocks. Its inner end is attached to the arbor and the outer end is attached to the drum. Okay, it has few rotation and also contains thicker band of steel. It releases powers when unwind. So as I said, it is used in the clock. So when the clock starts, so this used to be unwound. Okay. So now the first one is closed coil helical spring subjected to the axial load. So this you see the geometry of a closed coil. So this is a helix angle. Okay. So this is the diameter D. This is the diameter D, which is also known as the mean coil diameter. This diameter is the diameter of the wire, spring wire with which it is made. W is the axial load. N is the number of effective coils. So 1, 2, 3. Here there are 3 coils. So N is 3. C is the spring index, which is the ratio of the D upon D for the circular wires. So spring can be made of the square wires also. So if it is made up of the circular wire, then the spring index is D by D. The L is the length of the spring wire. G is the modulus of rigidity. And delta is the deflection of the spring. And theta is the angle of the twist. Okay. So we first go, what are the terms which are used in the spring? So first is the solid length. So when the compression of the spring is compressed until it comes with contact with each other, the spring is said to be solid. So here it is not solid. So when they are compressed together, the length formed will be a solid length. Okay. The solid length of the spring is the product of the number of the coils and the diameter of the wire. So solid length LS will be N into D, where N is the number of coils and D is the diameter of the wire. Second is the free length. Free length is the length of the spring in the free or unloaded condition. It is equal to the solid length plus the maximum deflection or the compression of the spring and the clearance between the adjacent coil when fully compressed. So mathematically, the free length is denoted by LF. So it is a solid length plus the maximum compression plus the clearance. So ND is the solid length, delta max is the maximum compression, and 0.15 of delta V take the clearance between the adjacent coil. So following relation is also used for calculating the free length. Now third term is important term is spring index, which is C. So spring index is defined as the ratio of the mean diameter of the coil to the diameter of the wire. So where D is the mean diameter of the coil and small d is the diameter of the wire. Fourth is the spring rate. The spring rate, it is an important term, also known as stiffness or the spring constant. So it is denoted by the K. It is defined as a load required per unit deflection. So load W. Deflection is W, delta. So W is the load and delta is the deflection of the spring. Next term is the pitch. So pitch of the coil is the actual distance between the adjacent coil when it is in the uncompressed state. So mathematically, it is equal to free length upon N dash minus 1, where N dash is the number of the coil. So here if you see, so this is the distance. So this will be the P. Okay. Now, when this helical spring is subjected to an axial load, so the situation is like this. So this theta is the total angle of the twist. Okay, this is a coil. So this is a load. So the angle, this is just like this. So d by 2 is a radius, you can also say, of the mean coil, radius r. And this d, small d, is the diameter of the coil. Okay. So this deflection angle, this deflection delta, where delta is a deflection of the spring, can be given by this relation. So L is equal to P into D into N. So this way we'll calculate. So thank you very much for a small introductory lecture on the spring. So in our next lecture, we will derive the expression when the spring is loaded with the axial load and the spring is under the action of the axial torque. So thank you very much for a patience listening.